Pisces, hello and welcome to Gina Moon. This is your new weekly tarot reading starting this new week of October the 23rd up until October the 30th. Without further ado, let's jump right into your reading. Remember, this is a general reading, so take the reading however it resonates. Again, it could be you towards somebody, somebody here towards you, and also take whatever resonates and leave what does not. This can also be for your sun, moon, rising, and your Venus placements. So if those are dominant in your chart, make sure to check those positions out as well. And you are starting with the dominant energy of the drumroll. You have here inner child healing. Okay, let's see what this is all about. So inner child healing. You also have here the number 23. Something very important will be happening on the 23rd of this month. So pay attention to that date. Also, how does the number 23 resonate for you? The number 2 plus 3 is equal to 3, 4, 5, so a lot of changes. Right now you are about to encounter or are currently encountering a lot of changes in your life. Now, don't be afraid of these changes because these changes are trying to take you to where you actually want to go in life, where you want to be or who you want to be with or who you want to become. So allow these changes, okay, into your life. Don't reject them. Don't avoid them. A lot of changes here. If you see the number 5555505 also, then that is an indication there to allow changes in, okay? Also, something very important may have happened on the 5th of the month as well related to this reading. However, here it says inner child. As you can see, there is a young girl there. And, you know, it's interesting because it says inner child healing. She's wearing a cape, like a Batman cape type thing, and she looks very confident. She's very confident. She's standing up, okay? You know, kind of like in that energy where she's looking out into the future in a very positive kind of optimistic way. Strength, confidence is what she is exuding as well, okay? Like she's about to become this rescuer, or she's about to save someone. Could be you saving you, okay? Because it does say inner child. So it says here, inner healing, inner child healing, going inside to explore our authentic feelings and parts of us that may have been rejected and labeled as inappropriate or too much by other people, especially by our caregivers. So right now there could be some kind of energy coming up to the surface as far as emotions. It could be happening, you know, in your family related matters. This could be happening in your career, family, friends, love, whatever this is. Okay, you take the reading however it resonates, whatever area of your life. But right now is a time for you to go inside yourself and to explore who you are, your feelings, the parts of you that at some point in your life may have felt rejected. Maybe as a child, you were rejected. You were told you weren't good enough. You were never going to amount to, you know, become anything. Perhaps there was some kind of energy there with parent figures, okay, some kind of trauma that needs to be healed from the past, some kind of old programming that has been keeping you stuck. And so right now, there's energies coming up to the surface that will allow you to go deep inside yourself in order to do that inner child healing. Of course, if this is not you, it could be somebody around you, okay, who is experiencing this. It says here, I have made and used excuses in order to control or sabotage my life or connections in my life. But I'm now realizing the only way to heal is to mend, acknowledge, and forgive my past. So this is all about a person here who has been using whatever it is that happened to them in the past, their past trauma, their past experiences, as an excuse for their behavior, as an excuse for why they're afraid to pursue certain things in their life, why they act certain ways, right? This is kind of like the energy of the victimhood mentality, okay? And so somebody here is becoming now, instead of a victim, a survivor, right? It's like, okay, yeah, sure. Yeah, maybe you went through that horrible experience. You had those horrible experiences, but you're no longer choosing to become a victim, because when you choose that victimhood mentality and you blame the world, you blame your parents, you blame people around you for everything that's happening in your life or has happened, and that's the reason why there can't be any improvements, whether this is you doing this or somebody around you doing this towards you, then you've got to realize that there is no a way forward from becoming a victim, from accepting that you are a victim, from you telling yourself that you're a victim. Whoever this is, whoever's telling themselves that they're a victim, you know, victims have graves. And you're realizing, somebody here is realizing, you know what? I want my life back. I want to create my life. I'm still alive. I don't want a grave, right? And so you're becoming now a survivor. Yeah, survivors have scars. You heal those scars and you continue forward to live your life. And so somebody here is realizing that they can no longer keep blaming the circumstances, people passed around them, okay, to sabotage, to control other people, to control connections. And so this realization brings in a lot of healing, and with it, it brings in a lot of liberation, acknowledgement, awareness, and forgiving your past, forgiving people, places, circumstances that perhaps caused you some kind of pain. But instead of you saying, oh, well, woe is me, that person did this to me, and that's why, you know, I'm not able to move on, that's why you're miserable, that's why this, why, that's why that, you know, you're saying, you know what, I'm glad that that happened. Okay, maybe not exactly glad that it happened, but there's something there in it where you're like, you know what, I'm glad that I'm learning this lesson. Because if it wasn't for that experience, if it wasn't for this person treating me this way, then I wouldn't be able to realize, you know, how far I've come, to realize how strong I am. Okay. So that kind of thing. So, inner child healing is what that is indicating at this particular moment. Let me know in the comments below what that's all about, what that is all pertaining to. Now we're going to be going into your past, present, future position, who and what is coming towards you, what is in your opportunity, also what is in your challenge position, and how to overcome that challenge. A lot of cards want to communicate. You've got a lot of message coming through, okay? Let's see. Remember, let me know in the comments below how this reading all resonates for you. You guys, even if it's just commenting down an emoji, letting me know how this reading resonates for you, it really helps support me and my channel. Of course, you can always give this video a thumbs up, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. All that good stuff also helps a lot. Okay. Now, I do see here some energies coming through the reading. You could possibly be dealing with the sign of Gemini. I see the sign of Leo, Aries, Capricorn. What other signs do we have here? Whatever other sign of the zodiac does not necessarily have to be any of those, but at the bottom of this deck, you have the Lovers. Okay, with the Lovers here, there are choices, decisions that you need to make right now. Okay, this is all about tests. Okay, you're being tested. A connection is being tested, or you feel like you're being tested. Now, this is coming about because there are some kind of choices, decisions that you need to make. Is this the right one for you? Are you the right one for them? Is this the right partner for you? Is this the right connection for you? Okay. Does this person make you feel better about yourself when you're around them, or do they make you feel worse? All of these questions that are coming up, this is part of that inner healing, right? Now, this could be a connection related to romantic situations. It could be family members, friends, coworkers, bosses, whatever, whoever this is. It's a divine connection. It's an undeniable connection. It's an undeniable union. You guys have been brought together for a higher purpose, for a higher reason. However, right now you're trying to make decisions about this connection particularly. Is it the right one for you? Is this meant to be? You could be tested right now. There could be choices, decisions. Do I stay? Do I go? That kind of thing. Okay. Let me know in the comments below which area of your life, career, love, finances, friends is pertained to, and what is going on as well. I love reading all of your comments. Now, in your challenge position, you also have here the Eight of Wands, the Fool, and the Devil. So part of your challenge during these 7 days, remember, it takes 7 days for these energies to develop. So you could be resonating with it right now, or it could be resonating with this in midweek, okay? Now, I also see here that part of your challenge has to do with you not feeling ready to open up. Either the lines of communication right now, you find it challenging for you to communicate, or somebody here is not communicating with you. For others of you, you feel like everything is going against you. There are delays, delay after delay after delay. Why is this not working out for me? Why do you keep feeling rejected? Why is that door not opening up for you, right? So I feel that there is some kind of energy here where you might be feeling a little bit hesitant to take a leap of faith into something new because, again, it's that self-sabotaging behavior, the devil. The devil is all about self-sabotage. Somebody here who is either stuck in a toxic connection, a toxic cycle, a toxic job environment, or any other kind of environment with family, friends, whatever this is. But I feel here that it could be a little bit difficult for you to detach yourself from either your own toxic ways, toxic behaviors, and or that of the relationship, a situation, a connection here happening. I feel that there could be also the energy where right now you find it challenging to make a move because you feel like foolish, like, oh no, I don't want to be rejected. I don't want to be looked at as a fool. I don't want to be judged, you know, that kind of thing. But I'm also sensing that part of this has to do with somebody here avoiding the reality of things, avoiding the actual inner healing, right? Because this devil energy, it comes in to tempt you. It's like temporary relief, a temporary pleasure, right? It's like trying to numb the pain in order to not feel it through connections that are toxic, through things that you do that you know are toxic, you know, addictions to drugs, alcohol, addictions to self-sabotage. It could be any kind of addiction. It could be any kind of cycle that is toxic right now. You, between you and you, between you and another person, you and an environment, that kind of thing. So it could be a little bit difficult for you to step back from that toxic type of energy, environment, person, place, or thing at this particular moment. But this is saying don't give up. Don't give up on yourself. Don't give up on yourself. Speak up. If you need help, speak up. Ask for help. Help is all around you. I feel that you may have spoken up in some kind of way, shape, or form, and you may have asked for help, but you felt rejected. But because you did it in such, there could have been some kind of energy where the other person felt like, oh, are you trying to manipulate them? Are you just being overly emotional just to try and, like, you know, being dramatic, you know, that kind of vibe. And so I feel that this time around, there's that energy where you can approach this person, approach the situation, but try to, it's not about avoiding, you know, your feelings. It's more so about being more practical. If you ask or you communicate with facts in a more logical kind of way, this person will hear you out, is what I'm sensing. I'm not letting you go, and you will hear from me very soon. Don't give up on me. Okay, so don't give up on yourself, on your inner child, on your inner healing. Don't give up. Don't give up on yourself. Okay, perhaps some of you guys are wanting to just, you know, oh, to hell with it. You know, nothing matters anymore. This is not going to work out. But this is telling you, no, don't abandon yourself. Just because somebody here abandoned you in some kind of way, shape, or form in the past, just because somebody here rejected you in some kind of way, shape, or form, that doesn't mean that you have to reject yourself, okay? For others of you, there's somebody here coming in saying, I'm not saying anything right now. They're not speaking up. Maybe the lines of communication are not open right now, but this person is saying, don't give up on me. I'm not letting you go. You will hear from me very soon, so don't give up on me. Now, in the recent past, and let me know in the comments below what that's all pertaining to. In the recent past, you have the Three of Cups, the Three of Pentacles, and the Nine of Pentacles. So I see that in the recent past, there was a lot of joy, happiness. You know, you guys were having fun together, going out. You know, there was a lot of energy of teamwork mentality, reciprocity. You felt very independent. You felt very at ease with yourself. You felt enchanted by this situation. You felt enchanted by this connection. You felt very good. There's a lot of good feel good type of energy, okay? The more that I see you, the more that I love and adore you, my heart cries out for you. And you felt very enchanted. You felt very good and at ease with that energy, okay? Now, let me know in the comments below what that was all pertaining to. Career, finances, friends, whatever that was. Love. In your present energy, you have Two of Swords, the Page of Pentacles, and the Three of Wands. So right now, you are undecided. You're kind of like trying to make a decision. You know that you have to make a decision, but you are overthinking it. You're overthinking it to the point where you're creating your own delay. Somebody here, whether you or this person around you, is overthinking a situation to the point where they might be creating a delay in the situation, okay? I'm also sensing here that there's this kind of energy where there's a potential for growth, okay? There's a potential to start something, but somebody may not feel like they're ready. Like, oh no, I still have to do this before I do that. I still have to take care of this before I do that, right? And so what this is saying is take a little bit of a step back in order to see what that person, what that situation can bring towards you instead of you always having to figure everything out for them, okay? I'm sensing that you will be getting some kind of an offer. It could be a little bit small of an offer, and you might be thinking like, oh no, that person's only offering me, you know, that little offer. That means that they don't really consider me. That means that this person is actually basically rejecting me because you feel like it's too small of an offer. Don't let your imagination take you in that direction, because I feel like this is an offer worth of giving it a go. Like, it could be a friendship offer. It could be, hey, let's join me in this adventure. Join me in this, you know, group or an organization, whatever this is. So I feel here that if you do take a little bit of a step back, you will see that you will be getting offers. It may not be what you imagined it to be or in the way that you imagine it to be, but the offer will be coming in. It could be a job offer. It could be career offer, friendship offer. It could be a love offer, but some kind of an offer there that might seem small, but it has a potential to grow into something more. This could be career-driven situations for you. Career-driven, love is on the back burner until I am financially stable, money motivated. You might be feeling like a person may be not sure about you right now, but that's because this person is actually more focused on making sure that they are going to be able to provide not only for themselves, for you, you know, make sure that they're stable. This person is very career-driven. For some, it could be you. You might be very career-driven yourself or this other person. And love right now is on the back burner for someone at this stage of their life until they are financially stable. Right now, there's somebody here who is very money-driven, money-career motivated, okay? But that doesn't mean that they're just offering you nothing. It means that they're offering you whatever they can offer you right now. Time, love, energy, money, effort, whatever this is. Let me know in the comments below what that's all pertaining to. Now, in the near future, you also have here the Wheel of Fortune, the Judgment, and the Four of Swords. So in the near future, you will definitely get what you want, okay? If right now you're feeling like nothing is happening, nothing is moving, the doors of opportunity are closing out for you, there's a reason for that. Sometimes things have to slow down in your life in order for you to take a time out to do the inner child work, to do the inner type of healing. Okay, a lot of times that's why that happens. Once you do that, you do the inner child healing, you will see that in the near future, all of these doors of opportunity are going to open up for you effortlessly, without you having to do or say anything, without you having to ask for help, because you've already done the work. So that's why right now, if things are slowing down, do the inner work, okay? So I'm sensing here that you're going to feel very lucky. There's going to be something that is destined to be yours, destined for you. Something here that nothing and no one, not even time, nothing can take away from you, okay? I feel that, again, the Wheel of Fortune in the near future is an indication that something that is meant to be yours, that is destined to be for you, whether it's a relationship, career, job, opportunity, it's coming in, okay? I see here that also there could be a potential reconciliation for some of you guys, where something that is destined to be yours, or you guys are destined to be together, to create something together, to bond together, whether it's in career, love, finances, friends, family, it's going to happen, okay? Naturally on its own. I'm also seeing here that you're going to learn a big lesson. You're finally going to hear the higher calling to change. You're going to finally stop ignoring those signals, those signs to, you know, kind of like, step into a new version of you. Learn a lesson. Okay, there's some kind of a breakthrough moment that is about to happen in the near future. And I feel like after this, you're going to realize, wow, now I can actually relax, right? That's the energy of you don't have to try so hard in order to get what you want, to convince someone of your worth, of your value. You're going to see that you're going to be able to feel more at ease with that energy. Okay, it's going to come to you. It's like you're going to start attracting things towards you. Sexual tension, you've been on their mind, all the things they want to do to you, sexual healing. Wow, in the near future, there could be somebody here coming in, okay, with regards to sexual healing. It could be healing sexually, right? You've been on somebody's mind, or somebody's been on your mind, will be on your mind in the near future. All the things that they want to do to you, or maybe you're going to be feeling a little bit sexually aroused, there could be an opportunity for you to bond in a sexual type of way with somebody, okay? Now, let me know in the comments below what that's all pertaining to. Excuse me. In your opportunity, you have the Strength, the Seven of Swords, and the Eight of Pentacles. So in your opportunity, I do see here that you definitely will be having the opportunity to step into your confidence, to step into your courage. If you haven't been feeling courageous enough to go for what you want, to do what you want, to be who you want to become, soon you're going to start feeling the energies of, oh, wow, I feel ready, right? Like you feel more encouraged by life. You're going to feel more courageous, more strong to do things, to end things, to, you know, be decisive on things that perhaps you weren't able to feel that way before because of this inner healing that you're doing. You're going to feel stronger, okay? For a lot of you guys, you're going to be meeting a person who's very different from you or somebody here who you already know who's very different than you. But instead of you two battling it out, arguing, you know, having discussions here that lead to separation, you're going to now learn how to enjoy their presence, enjoy their company, because you're now going to be more healed. You're not going to get triggered. You're not going to trigger them. They're not going to get triggered. And you're going to feel more at ease. Like there's that energy where instead of, you know, feeling like, oh, I can't even be around that person because they're going to trigger me. You know, they always make me feel certain ways. You're going to be feeling more confident about yourself because you're going to be feeling like, oh, wow, they said something that would have triggered me before, but now I don't feel anything about it. Like I'm clear, right? So you're going to find a way to compromise with somebody or work something out with somebody, whether career related, person, family, love, you know, friend, whatever, whoever this is. I'm sensing also that here you're going to have an opportunity to stop lying to yourself about something that you've been in denial about. Okay. Whether you've been in denial about somebody around you, you know, that has been lying and you've been making up excuses as to why you have to remain in that connection, you're going to find the strength now to be honest with yourself. Be honest with other people. The truth will be revealed. You're going to have an opportunity also to not feel like, you know, you have to go through the back door in order to feel at ease. You know, like maybe there's something here that has been making you feel uncomfortable and you haven't been courageous enough to confront it. Well, guess what? Now you're going to have the courage to confront people, situations, even yourself. Okay. Confrontation. You know, it's going to be something here, being honest with yourself about situations. And if you've been dealing with trust issues, you're going to be able to heal those trust issues. Okay. I'm also sensing here that there's an energy where you're going to have an opportunity to start showing up more for yourself, putting in the work, putting in the effort. You're going to be more focused on your passions. You're going to be more focused on your career, on making money. For others of you guys, somebody here around you is going to start, they're going to start kind of like noticing you, noticing your skills, noticing, you know, those things that you have that nobody else has. This could be in your career, in your job, in your love life, in your family life, whatever that is. But I see here that you're going to have an opportunity to really, you know, put in work into something, someone, a situation, yourself, that is going to be very gratifying and fulfilling for you. Okay. I'm seeing here that also there could be an energy or there is an energy where somebody here is going to start missing you. We may not be together right now, but my heart misses you dearly. Somebody here, and a message will be coming through where somebody here starts to miss you. Okay. Now we're going to be going into the extended. And in the extended is where we dive deeper into the situation, into the other person's subconscious thoughts about you, their deeper feelings, emotions for you, their next moves, actions towards you, how this entire situation is all going to turn out and unfold for you, what will be the final result, and we will end the reading with any messages from spirits. If you want to check out the link to the extended, you can find it down in the description box below, and also in the first comment that I've pinned down below as well. And if you are enjoying these readings, and if you do want to continue to support the channel, you can do so by commenting down below. Even if it's just commenting down an emoji, you guys, it really helps support me and my channel because as you guys have known, the YouTube algorithm has been hiding my videos and unsubscribing my subscribers. So again, to keep this channel going, make sure to comment down below, even with a cute little emoji. I really love reading all of your comments as well. Give this video a thumbs up, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, all that good stuff helps as well. If you are not getting my notifications, you can unsubscribe, then resubscribe, and then hit the little notification bell. After that, you can hit all, and that will be a way for you guys to now get the announcement. Hopefully that works for you. And if you want to watch all of your weekly readings from last week, this week, all of your monthly readings, your love readings, your blessings readings for this entire month, remember to always check the first comment that I pinned down below. I'm linking all those readings for you guys down there. Thank you all so much for your support. Take very good care of yourselves. And until next time, bye-bye. In the extended reading, I go into the other person's subconsciousness, their deeper thoughts about you, their deeper feelings for you, their next actions, moves, and more. And thank you all so, so much for all of your positive feedback for the extended reading. I am so glad that you guys are loving the extended reading so much. So again, if you want to check out the link to the extended, the link is down in the description box below. And I have partnered with Psychic Source so that you can receive 10 minutes for only $10 and an additional 3 minutes for free. I'm not the one doing the readings on Psychic Source, but you can choose any psychic of your choice. You can choose to either talk to them online or call them. Make sure to use my special discount code 26489 at checkout. The link to my Psychic Source partnership is down in the description box below. And check out my website at ginamoon.com. Click on shop. I do have new jewelry pieces, rings, bracelets, crystals, necklaces, and so much more for both men and women. So check that out at ginamoon.com and click on shop and follow me on Instagram at ginamoonofficial as I will be posting more on there.